Not too much open. Get the fresh fruit.
I know, me too.
Breakfast. Aha. Shall we?
Sure.
This place is going to be cold this afternoon.
Yeah.
That's a good breakfast.
That's what they're bringing into these restaurants.
Yep.
All the breads.
Mmm.
Hot dogs and hamburgers. Aperol spritz. Oh, did you get that? See the water down there?
Yeah, I do.
Old school, I think so.
Watch your step. You look
walk
down.
Walk up here or down there?
Down there on there. All the way around.
Do you see the layers in the stones?
Yeah.
Venerdì ho da tante le colleghe che sapevo che da rire.
Sì, prima da vasolo.
Venerdì.
Venerdì da una
vineyards up there. They're pretty.
Mm-hmm.
fish. Second person in a row cleaning up. Manarola. That's where we are right now. Venza. Montarosso. Oh, that looks cool. Manarola. See how Cornigli is way up high?
Yes.
That's all. It's way up high. It's starting to get busy.
Yeah.
What picture? This is cool. Italian, except one was
French,
British.
Italian, British, and the other one was from Switzerland, but he would have been Italian.
Yeah, look at that hotel up there.
Wow.
Let's get a drink right up there. Let's go. They got him. The sun wants to come up.
Yeah. Maybe it will, yeah.
go left. That's cute. Up and down these. Let's go up this down there. Excuse me. Well, I bought a hat. And I turned around. What the? It's a church. Cool. KK. Mm-hmm. Does she like to cook?
Yes.
How about a yeah. Don't back up. Let's go up here. Got a view from up here. Go for it. Wow.
Just the platform, there's no stores up here, you have to go down. Take away fried fish.
But that's good.
I bet it is too.
Ooh, before we make this turn, we gotta take a picture going out. They got numbers on the ground to store their boats. That's the place. Linda, that's the place.
Yes.
Ah oui,
ouais.
Le projet.
D'habitude, on va pas se
Rigor mortis? Rigor mortis, eh? Going from the train station to shopping and restaurants. We're hungry. It's 1 o'clock. So we'll get something to eat. Hopefully find a place that's not too busy. Tomorrow we leave for the Amalfi Coast. All day trip by train, and then a private driver picking us up in Naples. Huh. Cool.
Do you think they would have it in there?
Oh, I don't know. I'm just not worried about it right now.
That's right, man.
Isn't this nuts?
Yeah. There's a bunch of little bottles over there of all different flavors. So.
Shaped like nuts.
No, just the little ones so you wonder that had all the different.
That's that candy. No. Oh, Nini. I might get some our last day or something. Do you mind I bought them a beer?
I like it. They were happy that they had Guinness to drink. Here's an Irish bar. Wonder what they serve.
This is so loud.
Did those two leave? No, they're still there. Hang on, I gotta tell them one joke.
Ever. small islands. Those are the Ligali Islands. Those islands were very famous since the Greek times. Those islands, according to the blind Greek poet Homer, this was the spot where the sirens were living. The sirens were mythological creatures with the body of a bird, with the wings and the head of a woman. A bit creepy, eh, if you think about it. But yeah, according to the poet, the sirens were seducing the seafarers with their voice. Even if after seducing them, the sirens, the monsters, were killing them and eating them. So, and of course, the sirens were different from the mermaids that we see nowadays in the movies. So, ladies and gentlemen, what did Ulysses? He was curious to listen to the siren's voice, but he didn't want to be seduced and then killed. So he asked his friends, as he was very smart, he asked his friends to tie him up at the mast of the ship. So like that, he could listen to the siren's voice without entering the water. As well, he didn't want to lose all his friends. So he suggested them to put some wax in the ears, to cover the ear with the wax, so they could not listen to the siren's voice and not be seduced. Since that time, he is considered the inventor of the earplugs. Ancient Egypt, maybe they had even stranger taste than ancient Greece, but we don't want to judge them. So, ladies and gentlemen, let's go now ahead. We're gonna see in a while alongside over the cliffs. We put a lot of steel nets over the cliffs, like the one you can see here to the left, in order to prevent that rocks might fall on the road. Because we say the limestone is a very fragile rock, so because of the erosion of the wind, of the rain, of the salty air, rocks can easily fall on the road and cause accidents. So this is the reason why we put the nets. We already have crazy drivers like this one. We already have crazy drivers like the one that just overtook us. And we don't need the rocks to cause accidents, okay? No worries, we're gonna have a wonderful drive over the coast. So, ladies and gentlemen,
over the cliff.
Yeah. As well, don't be scared. Eh? We just flew a couple of times over the road, but we always survive. Now, ladies and gentlemen, we're gonna stop
here.
Like
brakes aren't
we're gonna
working.
Stop here on the side.
Oh my God!
Cheap.
Yeah, that's okay.